turn text into realistic speech using Python in 5 lines. So guys, have you ever wanted your Python app to speak like a human? Not just robotic beeps or lifeless monotone voices, but actual realistic human-like speech.
Simply dummy text of the printing and typesetting industry.
And you can see how realistic it is, right?
Has been the industry's standard dummy text ever since the...
So in this video, I am going to show you how to use powerful library called edge-tts to convert your text into ultra-realistic AI speech using just 5 lines of Python code. So let's dive into our video. Now before I start, I want to request you, please do like, share and subscribe. That's going to really motivate me to make more similar kind of videos, and it's going to also help YouTube algorithm to share this video with many viewers like you. So first, let's invoke our PyCharm ID, create a new project. Let's give the project name as text to speech, and I'm going to also check this create a welcome note, click on create. So our project is rightly created, and you can wipe out everything that are there on welcome note and go to terminal to install one Python package. So just simply type pip install edge-tts, hit enter. So we are going to basically use this edge-tts package, which is just a wrapper around Microsoft Edge's neural TTS or text-to-speech service, and it's going to give you access to the same ultra-realistic voice that are used in Azure, but with zero API keys or any cost. So it will be totally free. So the only thing is, you need to have Python 3.7 and you need to have active internet connection and just few minutes of your time. So our package is rightly installed. Let's write those 5 lines of code. So first I'm going to import async io and then edge-tts. Then I'm going to create our main method and I'm going to call function communicate. So edge-tts.communicate, and it accepts a couple of parameters. One is text and voice. So first I'll provide some text, something like sample text, and I'm going to give voice as yen for English, and then in for India, and nirja neural for Indian accent. That's it. Now I'm just going to save our file. So call our save method, and let's give the file name something like test.mp3. And finally, I'm going to run my main method. That's it. So just simply write this much and just simply click on this run button. And there you go. You can see that our sample test.mp3 file is rightly created. So let's play this file.
Sample text.
So our file is rightly played. Let's pick some dummy text and use that to convert our text to speech. So I'll just copy this dummy text and I'll just place it over here, and I'm going to click on this run button again. So again, it is rightly generated. Let's play our audio again.
Lorem ipsum is simply dummy text of the printing and typesetting industry.
And you can see how realistic it is, right?
Lorem ipsum has been the industry's standard dummy text ever since the 1500s, when an unknown printer took a galley of
with our Indian accent as well,
to make a typed specimen book. Edges of letterset including versions of lorem ipsum.
It is very realistic, isn't it? So yeah, you can also try with some other voice. So can get that list. So just simply type python-m edge-tts --list-voices, hit enter. So that's going to give you this entire list, and from here you can pick any voice that you want. So this en signifies English language, and then the country name, and then the neural net that they have prepared. So for India you will get these three. So this couple of ones are the female voice and this one is male. So you need to just simply change this language code, and you need to just simply put that over here and just replace it, and then when you build it, going to generate that male voice if you want. And for referring this entire code, you can follow our article on our website. So I have prepared this detailed text along with all the steps with code. You can just simply refer it for your reference as well. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and also press that bell button to get notified for future videos. I'm going to post more interesting videos on Python on this channel along with this detailed article. So don't forget to like, share and subscribe. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.